In this video, I will show you how to open in SPSS an existing dataset, and I will open one of the datasets that goes along with your textbook. To do that, first I have to open SPSS, so I'm clicking on the SPSS icon. Now this version looks a little bit different because it's a version for Mac, but if you're not using a Mac, you shouldn't worry because the same steps should be followed with both versions. The reason I'm using this version now is because I thought it might be helpful for those of you who are using a Mac. So you know that when you're open SPSS, you're getting one of these windows where you're being asked whether you want to use an existing data source. So I'm just going to click OK now. And then you see a window that contains all of the folders on your computer. And I saved all of the SPSS datasets that go along with your textbook from the CD to my computer in this particular folder. You can also download these datasets from the stats portal. The folder is called SPSS, and I'm going to Chapter 2. Now, I don't see anything here because SPSS, by default, is searching for files that have the .sav extension. To see any other kinds of files, I have to click on this drop-down menu and select the All Files option, and then I can see everything that is saved in this particular folder. I'm going to select the Over 65 dataset and then click Open. And here it is. I see that the dataset contains two variables, the variable state and the variable percentage. The other way to do this, if SPSS is already open, is either to go to this folder and click on it, and then again you have to change this option to see all the files, and so you are going to select the dataset that you want. Or you could go to the menu, and from the File drop-down menu, you are going to select Open, and then select Data. And again, you are going to have to change this, and you will be able to select any of the datasets that you want. So now I already have this dataset open. If I want to find out more about these variables, I could go to the Variable View tab, and I will see that the state variable is obviously a nominal variable, while the percent variable is a scale variable or a quantitative variable. And it represents the percentage of individuals who are 65 years old or older in each state. If I want to work with these variables and conduct some kind of analysis, I could go to, say, Graphs, Chart Builder, and let's do a bar graph. So I'm going to drag the bar graph over here. On the x-axis, I will put my categorical variable, which is the variable state, and on the y-axis, I will put my quantitative variable, which is percent 65. I see that the count was changed to mean here, so I have to change it back, go to this menu and select value instead of mean, and then click apply and click OK. And here is my bar graph. I can see all the states listed here, the percentages on the vertical axis. I can see that a smaller percentage is here while the highest is over here. If I want to include this bar graph in a report or an assignment, I could click on it and click copy. And then I can just paste it into a Word document. And then I can just continue writing about it.